Thank each and every one of you out there that have been supporting me from day one. All the real support, all the fake support, all of it has helped for my good and has helped put me on the map in a way that I never even imagined would happen. Blessings have been showering down on your girl, and all I have to say is thank you. I just have to say thank you to each and every one of you, because it makes a huge, huge difference in everything that I do. So I just say thank you so very much for everything. Everything. So I'm out here in these streets, you guys know, as usual, making magic happen, all that great stuff. Making some big things pop. Making some things happen. You know, the wheels are in motion, the ink is still drying. Yeah. We're making some magic. Definitely making some magic happen. And I just wanted to say on this Sunday, whatever it is that you want to do, you have the power to do it. Now, you can, A, cultivate that power, make it into something beautiful, something that you've never seen, something that no one's ever seen. That's really where you really have power, is when you create something that no one else has ever seen in life. You can make some things happen. You can definitely make some things happen. So that is pretty much the gist of it. Pretty much the gist of how things can compile and create, and wonderfulness comes from it, you know? Wonderfulness. Yes, I use the word wonderfulness. And that's my word, so get over it. Anyways, I'm jamming to some Joss Stone, Color Me Free. I love this record. I just found it when I was cleaning out my car, and so I just been blasting it all week. I mean, just, you know, could have been you type stuff, girlfriend on demand. What? So I've been enjoying this Joss Stone. I love Joss Stone. Her voice is amazing. It is out of this world. Beautiful voice of this generation. Totally underrated starlet. Love her to pieces. But yeah, so I'm enjoying the weekend. Okay, so I don't know if I told you guys, but I'm actually doing kickball this year. Yeah, I'm doing kickball. So with kickball, you got practice. So I've been at practice. I've been on time, you know. Our coach has not necessarily been prompt in his appearance. But yeah, so I've been doing kickball practice, and I am the least athletic person on the entire team. I am the least. I have no athletic know-how. This is all brand spanking new, but you guys know that I like to take on a challenge. It's something else that I don't necessarily know how to do wholeheartedly, but just continuing to work and to practice and to get things in, get it done. So I've been working to make some things happen, and I'm gonna put the work out there. But you know, I'm still very rusty. I honestly and truthfully, I was the fat kid that no one wanted to have on their kickball team. I was the little husky kid. Nobody wanted to play on their team because they knew I could run, and it's a running sport essentially. And I'm learning that more and more, and coaches reminding us more and more. So shout out to B-Dub. That's our coach out there, B-Dub. Definitely holding it down for us, but definitely working us like it's for real. So he's trying to make sure that we're ready, we're set, and we're getting into game mode, so to speak. So he's been definitely doing that. But yeah, so we had a couple of, he likes to do, what do you call them, demos, demonstrations, where we practice different things, different techniques. And my main thing was trying to get from home to first and then curving to the right, because that basically makes it an official play or whatever the case is, because you have to curve to the right. So as I'm, you know, I kick the ball, I'm running. Coach is coming up alongside me. He's yelling stuff and saying all kind of crazy stuff. And just out of nowhere, I just scream. I give a crazy, you know, Nightmare on Elm Street scream. I don't know where it came from. I don't even scream. I'm not a screamer. So I just like screamed and I kept running out. I got to the base and I curved to the right and everything, but the entire, everybody was cracking up. They were cracking up laughing. It was so funny. And in the heat of the moment, like, you know, Coach, he is dying. He is like almost like topping over, like laughing at me. And he's like, "Well, why did you scream?" I'm like, "I don't know, I hate you." But that was not the case. I do not hate my coach. He's an amazing athlete, and I continue to learn from him every week. So beat up. Lay to pieces, keep doing what you do. It's definitely helping us improve, helping me improve. I know that much. Be it that I'm not an athlete, I'm not the athlete type. I'm just not. There's nothing athletic really about me. Now, if you want me to, you know, touch my nose to my knee, I can do that. And, you know, I flexibility at this world. Yoga, Pilates help with that. But, like, as far as, like, sprinting, I've never had to sprint in my life. So, this is all new to me. It's all very, very new. But B-Dub is pretty awesome. Pretty awesome coach. We were definitely blessed with a great coach. And yeah, it's going to be an interesting season. So, you know, getting game face on, that's number one. And then remembering the rules and trying to stay in compliance with all of them. It is a challenge. So we're making history. We're making some things happen. We're making some things pop. We will see what happens. Our first game is April the 9th. I'll let you guys know closer to it where it's going to be, because I don't even know where it's going to be. But we'll see how that turns out there. But yeah, if there's something out there that you want to do, jump out there and do it. People will always offer their unsolicited opinion. You didn't ask nan one person what the heck you know that they think about whatever it is that you're dealing with. People always want to offer up their opinion, and it's like, it's not even just, oh, it's the old generation. It's a lot of young generation people too that just want to be heard. They just want to put their 2 cents on it. They don't care what's going on with you in your life. They could care even less. They just want to put out what they want to put out, how they want to put it out there. And people shouldn't do that. People shouldn't be like that. But that's just the way that it is. So just know that people are going to do that. You can always respectfully decline, because I've had to do that several times. And some people will say, "Oh, well, you're rude," or, "Oh, you're disrespectful." No, I just don't want to hear your bullshit. That's just real. I really just don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear all that. All that negativity is just, it poisons. And people don't understand how that stuff can happen, how it can actually poison what you're trying to do. Some people may not realize it, but a lot of people are very aware of what they're doing. They just want to plant that seed of despair in your head. And as soon as they plant that seed, it may start to grow. It may take root. So, negative people, I would say stay away from. Steer away from them. And if you're unfortunate enough, like some of us, that have family members that also don't believe in what we're doing, you have to distance yourself. Doesn't mean that you don't love these people, doesn't mean that you don't care about them, but if they're not going to support your dream, then they're going to poison it. That's just real. That is just real. And it may be a situation where you just have to keep your personal separate from your business, which is what you should do anyways. But especially if it's people that are being negative, you won't be able to share those great business successes with them because they're not going to understand it, and they're not going to want to understand it, and they're going to be hell bent on just being negative. And as crazy as that sounds, I mean, it just is what it is. So live your dream. Anybody to tell you that you don't? I'm getting tongue tied on this Sunday morning. Thank you, Lord. Sunday morning, rain is falling, but if there is someone to tell you that you can't do what you want to do, oh, ain't nobody from the old neighborhood ain't never did that. Girl, you can't do that. Ain't nobody ever did that successfully. You turn around and tell them, don't believe me, just watch. Watch what I do. Watch me make history. Watch me make it happen. Because they don't want to see you make it happen. That's like the worst thing that could possibly happen. Oh my gosh, she actually did it, what she said she was going to do. They don't want to see it. And most times than none, moving in silence is the real get-go. That's when you really just get just gut punch them. Just gut punch them up. Gut punch them. They don't even see it coming. They're like, wait a minute. Exactly. Make it happen, Captain. Make it happen. Anyways, I love you guys to pieces. Keep doing what you do. Don't let anyone discourage your dream. Anything that you want to do that is brand new, you may be the only one to have that idea ever in life. You ever thought about that? And if you don't make it come to fruition, then it may never come to fruition. So, make it happen. Do what you do. And know that if no one else has told you this day, this week, this month, this year, Ash loves you. I love you very, very much. Thank you so very much. AshSaidit.com, 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 info@AshSaidit.com, info@AshSaidit.com, 1-800-274-4936. And I'll see you guys across social media @OneLoveAsh. Yeah. Deuces.